Now, I know you're thinking, Kato, you look a little hot and bothered. Well, I'm not bothered, but I'm hot and sweaty. I'll tell you why. It's because of our first guest. Let me tell you a little bit about her. She is incredibly beautiful. And she's a talented actress who played the character Danielle in True Blood. And like her, I become a wolf at midnight along with every other guy in our studio. Hey, let's watch a clip of her in action. I'm so excited she's here.
I can't tell y'all what to believe, but I will say this. I believe.
What does he mean, end of days?
A war. Between vampires and humans. And God be damned if you get caught in the middle.
I'm in.
Jamie, hi there.
It's Kato.
It's Jamie Gray.
We got another guest on the show.
Jamie Gray Hyder.
Mm-hmm. Kato, get to the other guest.
What? Oh, the guy that's saving the world? Oh, yeah, big deal. Yes, we have another guest. We'll talk to you in a second. Mm-hmm. Our next guest, you're going to like this. He's a brilliant scientist and a graduate from Harvard. He's an all-around genius, and guess what he's doing? He's saving the Earth one water drop at a time.
Yay,
yippee, we love the Earth. Let's watch a clip of this guy in action. You'll love him.
In 2001, I formed a company by the name of Select Plastics. We were wiped out by oil-contaminated floodwaters. After the flood and seeing what oil-contaminated water can really do, I became obsessed with coming up with a simple solution to filter oil from water. We have the technology with OPFLEX to remove the oil at the source of contamination.
I wonder if I can get oil out of my hair, but we'll talk about that in a second, because we have to do a commercial. Scott Smith, I'm so excited to meet you. Hey, pound it, my man. It's a sports show. Pound it. No, give one to Jamie. I guess he's never done this before. You've done this before. In Wisconsin, yes. I don't know where you're from.
Milwaukee.
That's where we do that. Milwaukee, that's where I'm from. Commercial. I got to talk to you about sports. Be right back at Tailgating with Kato. Jamie, stop it. I have a relationship. So Jamie's going, Kato, why does the guy keep holding this pink thing? Why don't you explain what this...
This started in the Gulf of Mexico. Before I get there...
That's starfish?
Yeah. And during the BP spill, it was green.
Oh, the British Petroleum spill?
Yes. But I'm here today. We're announcing a partnership with the American Cancer Society. I've created a pink product. 10% of all our sales go to fund research.
Okay, so what do you... tell me what you're inventing. So this is... What is this? Is this a sponge?
It's a sponge.
And it does
it's
what?
Simple. It absorbs oil and carbon contaminants and repels water. And it will even absorb blood and metals, even silver. We've proven that out in Brooklyn, New York, where there's massive contamination, and right here in Santa Monica.
Well, I mean, you've got to...
Jamie
can use that. She loves silver and gold.
Well, I'm thinking all the blood splattering you see on True Blood, they could clean it, you know, we can clean it all down.
Yeah, and we need a whole lot of those.
You can actually wring it out, and you'll see. You can actually wring it out and reuse it, so you can actually stem the vampire attacks.
So wait a minute, when you collect oil...
There you go.
You can ring it out and they can just put it...
Who said Scott had funnier lines than me in the show? Hello, who's the writer? Scott, you didn't tell me you came prepared. So can you absorb oil and still wring it out and use that oil?
32 times, and BP, we used it an average of 25 times in the Gulf of Mexico.
What took BP so long to come to you?
They didn't come to me, I went to them. Everyone told me the product wouldn't work on oil, so I went down and chartered a boat and... got in a boat with a fisherman, and he said 40,000 people before you. And
did you guys have fish sticks? Or is that a different one? That's Mrs. Paul.
No,
I get him confused. That was our first date, by the way. She loves fish sticks. This girl, tartar sauce breath, I was like, I like it.
This is a serious conversation.
He's a friend now. I can do that. The serious part, I'm all about this. American Cancer Society gets 10% of sales, but where do the sales come from? Who buys that?
The oil spill contractors and consumers. Everyday oil spills, one thing we're going to talk about today is...
Yeah.
The oil spill, according to the EPA, is greater than the BP spill just by everyday Americans.
Wow.
Olive oil, sesame seed oil, it blocks sunlight. More importantly, one car oil change can contaminate 1 million gallons of water. So you think all those, when you get your car changed, do you think they always really dispose of the oil? When that goes down the drain, 200 million gallons a year, according to the EPA, gets spilled down the drain by Americans. That's the size of the BP spill. every single year.
That's terrible. So, that's why I think our water is, everybody's hearing about water being contaminated. They test the water. I live in an area that the water gets tested every month, and I don't want to brag where I live, but it's nice. But the water's tested in the, it's part of, I guess, the government, and it's free from contaminants. Is that possible?
Yeah, I don't know. Santa Monica,
not Santa Monica.
Santa Monica, where they dump the stormwater out.
Yeah.
People go in the water 3 days, they get sores, they get sick. And even with what we know with the technology, there's still a lot more we don't know. That's why we're doing the American Cancer thing. We want to fund research, and we think we want to focus what's in the water. You see all these dead dolphins and people washing on the shore, but no one ever asks what's in the water.
Right.
So we have
that
the ability
so
to
exciting.
Fingerprint and detect what's in the water.
That's great. And I think the important thing also would be the if that thing can actually heal sores.
Yeah.
You've really got to
mention it's also simplicity. I spent a lot of time in Brooklyn, New York, Gowanus Canal. It's heavily contaminated. And I was actually in the canal, in the oil, the day Facebook went public.
Wow.
Animals were clean with this material and mitts. You'll see the mitts when we do the demo.
Guys, do not go away. We're going to do a demonstration with Scott. I'm telling you, Scott, I'm excited. I cannot wait for this incredible demonstration. Scott's going to do it. Jamie and I are going to make out. No, we're going to watch it. Come right back. Come right back. Tailgating with Kato. Okay, now listen, we're going to do a demonstration of this right now, and I'm no fool, but there are no fish. There are no fish, Scott, so I hope it's a good trick. What are you going to be doing?
Well, I'm going to be demonstrating, according to the EPA, 200 million gallons, how people dump all oils down the drain.
Wow.
And how it blocks sunlight. And as I previously explained, I was in Gowanus Canal the day Facebook went public for 100 million, and I was crawling around in sewage and everything, and I looked, and there's a YouTube video, and said, you know, we can practically cure, you know, cancer, extend lives. We can't simply clean our water. And it's amazing. This is simple, and it works, and it's almost unbelievable.
And
it's the only product BP actually put on the cover of USA Today and talked about in November of 2010.
And obviously these contaminants cause cancer.
So we're going to be dumping in, you know, olive oil, but that in the water. I was over at Costa Concordia, the Italian spill, and when that olive oil in the water, it will kill eelgrass. It blocks sunlight. Subsurface life needs oxygen just like us.
Well, I'd say that because I was taking her to lunch today at Costa Concordia.
But we have to put, since we're dumping motor oil, we have to put put these gloves on.
Hey, this is where the part of the show gets scary.
I can't.
Is this the first time seeing me?
I can't get the glove to fit. What do I do?
Oh, please.
The glove doesn't fit my hand.
Oh, please. Don't say that joke. Dr. Kato at your service. Anyways, we're going to.
So to go quickly here.
Me like a mute.
I can't get the gloves to fit, so I'm going without gloves.
Do your glove. Do your thing.
So here we go. Here's olive oil. You cook with it. We're just going to dump in. That concoction from last night. These vampires. This is blood mixed with tequila. But just as this will.
Oh, man.
Now, that is oil and?
Yeah, and it's transmission fluid,
too. Is she supposed to do that?
And this is what happened. Oh, yeah. You can put yourself. And this is what people do every. This is what people. You can stop. This is what people do every day. Just pretend every day oil spills 200 million gallons.
This is our drinking water.
Going down the drain.
This demonstrates our drinking water, right?
Yeah, it's a wonderful cocktail every day. So now what you do is you put this.
Let me throw my football. Take this football, Angela. Good catch.
And take a mitt and put it in there. It's all about surface area. So this is a bilge boom.
Stick it in there?
Yep, just put it in.
And
put it in. Put it in oil.
Like this?
Yeah, put it in the
oil.
Yeah, just everybody put it in.
And this would lay in the water in the ocean or lakes?
It lays in the water and it absorbs 32 times its weight and then you wring it out.
I totally smell that oil. Isn't this terrible?
So
I feel like I should be working at Pep Boys.
Now you can pull it out. And now you
put. Hey!
No. No.
Please. We just
wait, hold that up over this. See, and see how the clear water comes out, and then you can wring it out. This is what BP did. Wring that out, and you'll see the oil that comes out of there. Wring that out.
Oh, that's oil coming out? Look
yep.
at that. Oh, again, I'm touching it.
So it repels the water, and the oil comes out, and this is clearing.
Look at the oil. You've got to see this. Boy, it says 4 minutes into it, and look what's happening.
Ugh.
And then you can also go to waste energy plants and generate. You can take all this contamination that can be bad for your health, and you can generate waste energy. 16,000 BTUs per pound. Average waste is 8,000.
Okay, you got to kind of see this right.
See the clear water. How the clear water just flows out.
Yeah.
That's the clear water being repelled, so it holds the oil. Now squeeze this, just like what BP did, and reuse the 25 times in the Gulf. You can see.
Okay, this is unbelievable.
See the oil coming out?
Yes, I feel it.
Can you get me a glove that fits?
I can't. Oh, can we talk to someone with that? By the way, don't come back on the set with that dirty hand, please. He's doing the trial quotes from the glove that doesn't fit. It's 2012, Scott. I love you. Okay, so now and then you just put it back in the water, right? And reuse
it? Yes, put it back in the water and reuse it.
I love that.
And it's definitely not rhubarb pie where we come from in Wisconsin.
I love that. It's real rhubarb there in Wisconsin.
I wish it was rhubarb.
And you can see here how it had just cleared all the oil out. And this is just a few minutes. I mean, normally in a spill, you want to
okay,
explode
so here, here's the question now. Who, seeing a demonstration, who's not jumping on this? Is it because you're, how many people work for you? Why is this not everywhere in the world?
Of about 70 people, and it's starting to grow. But to answer your question, it's our elected officials. They're not talking about the water issues. It's the single greatest threat to our future, no matter what side of the aisle.
Yeah,
and the elected officials will say, well, if you expose the contamination, we're going to scare the tourism revenue. And I don't understand that logic, because it's about the future. It's about knowing what's in the water. We take the standpoint, we're just a small part of the solution. We want to know what's in the water and do something about it, because we can clean it. And we've got a bunch of projects where we pull surfactants and laundry,
right,
and they're just coming to fruition, and sales are growing very rapidly. So we're actually pulling biological and chemical oxygen manners.
Wow. Another question I got to ask you is, what does this have to do with True Blood?
No, I'm kidding.
Well, I think there's really vampires out here. You have a den at your house. Why don't you just admit it?
I like vampires. Hey, the question I do really want to know is I still don't get why no one is seeing this and going, give me. I don't know how do you sell
the
stuff?
Issue is
how much does something cost?
There's an entrance. There are companies out there, and I won't use their names, but they definitely know who I am.
Well,
they get paid to fill the landfills.
Okay.
And what the government, what our elected officials and those running for office need to do,
right,
is they need to mandate that you get that when there's a spill, you got to pull the oil out of the water, not fill the landfills, because we're running out of land too.
Yeah.
And you can take this to waste the energy, and you can reuse the oil. We've got people, laundry firms reusing and selling
oil.
You're
like a movie that would be made in your life. I'm not kidding him. It doesn't seem like that's this great story of what you did. You did in New Orleans. You saved. I saw you were putting stuff in sewers. And
it seems simple too.
It does.
Well,
seem
and
simple.
We've
and
taken
you got a part, by the way. You're in it. The film.
We've taken this and put it down storm drains. Every storm drain, and it absorbs and it prevents the water from being contaminated.
I can't believe this.
The key is, I'm not a magician, and everyone, the golf spill, I refuse to go. I was with the fishermen living and listening to them, mm-hmm, and I always say, you know, you can always tell a person from Harvard, but you can't tell them much. It's really true. I went there so I can laugh, but you got to listen to the people. You can't become experts from your computer screen, and I love it. People
we're from Wisconsin together and went to Harvard also.
That's yes.
Harvard was like high school. we're going to go to commercial, but I'll tell you what we have coming up. We're going to have more of this. As a matter of fact, one of the best parts of our show is it's on Friday. It's Potluck Friday. It's called Crew Questions. We have our crew coming in. They're going to ask questions to everybody here. So get ready to put your thingy cap, and you are probably going to get a lot of questions.
Ooh.
And it's going to be fun. So right now, hey, you want to take a jacuzzi? We're going to do a commercial. Come on. I don't care. I'm taking my top off.
It's
right
clean
back.
Now.
It's clean. Oh, boy. You know, we have our day of Friday, Potluck Friday, where we have the best guest being Jamie Gray Hyder. Scott Smith, very common name, by the way, Jimmy Hyder. And this is where the crew comes in and asks questions. And we have stand up?
No.
Oh, sit down. And what is your name?
My name's Cam. How's it going, guys?
Cam? Okay, Cameron, what do you
think? Huge fan, Kato. Number one fan of yours.
I love you. Thanks so much.
All right.
Question?
Yeah, this question's for Scott. So, does this material work essentially like an air filter would? Like, could you theoretically put it in front of like any water treatment center or river and it just all flow through it and like filter it out?
That's a really good question. The polymer it's made from attracts oil like a magnet and repels water, but it's also its open cell structure. So it's basically, I'm like almost like a glorified bread maker, and it's porous, so it actually filters. And we've got applications right now, you know, in New York City, where they don't know what to do with all the effluent from water and storm drains, where we're removing dissolved solids, grease, surfactants, and everything.
Excellent question. Better answer. Scott, let's run that clip because you told me to. this is amazing what he does. I'm not kidding you.
I'm literally sweeping the crude oil or mopping it up right out of the water with clear water around.
That's what you were wearing.
You've been here for half an hour. Already soaked up about 8 gallons.
Wow. It's all oil.
You can see it's just been in the water a half an hour. It's actually very heavy. And here we are in a beautiful rainy day. And here's some thunder and lightning. I think we better get to shelter.
and he'll get struck.
You know what? You should have your own show, by the way, because you've got the crazy energy that really makes something go, and what you're doing for the environment. Honestly, I've been joking the whole show. I'll get serious. What you're doing is amazing and helping out the entire world with what you're doing, and I applaud
that
you.
Was great.
And I hope everybody can accept that they will go to you, use the sponges, and save the world, man. We can, because we both love water.
Well, thank you very much. I appreciate it. And you got to have a sense of humor. Thanks for this, because it's so stressful trying to do this and get people's attention.
Yeah, it's so much fun
to
do.
You got to learn to laugh.
I'll tell you what. I wish that you would tell Carol and her family that, because they haven't laughed yet. You got to watch this. It's Tailgating with Kato. And every show, I think about things we did and how much we grew. I just sort of mentioned, remember, everybody, it's a jungle out there. Always look out for number one and be careful not to step in number two.